Like, yeah, if they're likable in-game, in story, then... Oh! Yeah, he's made it! The fuck, is he shaking his ass at us? Hey, Joe, what the hell? That's not appropriate, man. Oh, wait, are we beginning? Oh, shit, it begins. Yo, trailer!
We've arrived at the final phase. The winner of this match will take the final spot among the victors.
Oh, wait, is that Mavuika just fucking sitting there?
From this point forward,
oh shit,
about the real world no longer applies.
Whoa. Okay, more ruins.
There's something in the depths of this place that feels familiar, yet also foreign.
What is okay, this is not Natlan.
It's not merely a trial to determine the strongest among us.
Among us.
Upon which to
show she just sits up there and just watches the fight. Yo, my boy.
The pilgrimage is not only to select strong warriors, but also
oh yeah, this is another thing I'm excited for too. The fucking traversal in this area.
Natlan is only safe from the invasion of the abyss.
It seems like each character has their own like special traversal like shit. Whoa, what are those enemies? Whoa, is that Kinich bursts? Holy shit. Oh, who is that he's fighting? Oh, it's one of the, like, freaking dinosaur people or something. Yo!
Guess I'll have to wait until the next pilgrimage.
What the? Is that a legit dinosaur right there?
I'm still not sure why Arwayup chose me of all people.
Yo, Pokemon, let's go!
Just the combined efforts of the then Pyro Archon
and heroes from every wait, do we get to ride on these freaking birds?
Even so. The effects of the invasion lingered for hundreds of years.
The invasion?
To be reversed little by little.
Our current Archon achieved it only.
Dude, there's so much wildlife in Sitsane.
The result was obvious from the beginning.
Oh my god, having a breakdance competition, holy shit.
This time and become a true warrior.
Yo, this region looks sick so far.
Fighting the abyss, we've realized things aren't quite so simple. The abyss has invaded the Night Kingdom. And has the capacity to read the memories of this land at any given moment.
The Night Kingdom, huh?
Only those who triumph over the abyss are going to be revived. Defeat not only means death, but also the destruction of your ancient name, preventing it from ever being inherited again.
You heard something from here, didn't you?
Each, what is the meaning of this? Only one way to awaken.
Whoa, what's happening?
From your willful blindness.
I'm trying to keep quiet just to listen to the dialogue.
You'll die if you try to make your way forward. Why don't you just give up?
Whoa! Don't tell me we're fighting that thing. Oh shit! Oh, these might be the world bosses actually.
Sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
Natlan is on the verge of destruction. It's very possible our nation has less than a year before total devastation.
Once your ancient name disappears, there's no coming back.
Yeah, what's this about ancient names disappearing? Yo, Chasha!
No! Why can't I find him? Why?
Every great
Whoa.
Power.
Okay, maybe this nation is surrounded by war after all. This is just 5.0, right? Oh, shit. Is that a new abyss enemy?
We shall unite the tribes. And save Natlan from its impending doom.
Yo, we back, baby. Genshin is so back.
Use the gnosis in your hands.
Oh shit, capitano.
I don't know what you mean, but it sounds like this is a.
Mavuika's a great sword wielder. Yo.
Your plan has.
Oh my god.
And now it falls to me to create new rules for Natlan.
Oh.
We're
really about to watch this duel. Yo, she has a fucking glowy hair. Sick shit. Flowers are pleasant on the sun scorched sojourn. Dude, capitano. My man, I got hyped as soon as he ripped off his freaking jacket. Hey, our man. Dude, Capitano. Okay, so Capitano is cryo, that's for sure. And oh my god, he's gonna duel with the Pyro Archon. Are you serious? Holy shit. Holy fucking shit. I cannot wait. Oh my god, that's gonna be so great. Yeah, it seems like he's a sword user, while Mavuika's a great sword user. Like, oh my god. I'm giving her my Wolf's Gravestone. What's this? Oh, like behind the scenes stuff. Yo, look at this place. Yeah, Natlan looks sick so far, and the story just seems intense right off the bat. Oh, I can't wait for it.
欢迎来到原神5.0前瞻特别节目，我是你们老朋友大伟哥。大伟哥，今天我们又请到了我们的项目组老朋友啊，战斗设计师鸡哥，我们的IP负责人小罗浩。
Hello， 大家好，我
I always appreciate you at these dev streams. Oh man, hey Hoyo, can you just release mavuika already? I want them, and also capitano too. Please don't kill off capitano. Don't give capitano the signore treatment, please.
啊，我是你们的老朋友小罗浩，那个很荣幸还是。Dude,
that trailer was fucking sick. I legit got goosebumps. Oh my god. Mavuika versus capitano 1v1. Oh man, that's gonna be hype to see. Holy shit! Can we receive primo gems? Questions regarding Natlan. It's one of those questions as when now my week will be playable. Is Capitano one of the strongest harbingers? It's said to be, yeah, that he's one of the strongest harbingers, like physically wise. Whoa, what the hell?
那这次就是新的大世界移动体系，那选择它作为原神纳塔版本新玩法的原因是什么呢？
Oh, just like he's holding like a little clean. Oh, he's like a little yai fox plushie in the background. Oh man. I want one of those, honestly.
我先说一个比较大的概念啊，就是原神它其实是一个开放世界游戏，当然这个大家都知道，对吧？但在我们的理解里面，其实开放设计游戏它更关注的两条，一个是关于玩家交互行为本身。 以及交互行为带来的反馈，对，那其实大家也都知道，就是在原神的过往的版本里面，其实我们一直有一个叫元素的概念。那元素这个概念本身呢，也是交互反馈的一种体现。就比如说我去拿火元素打一下冰雾花，这冰雾花可能就
I mean right. Wait, are they gonna say we're gonna get new elements of reactions in this game? No way, right?
体现。
对，那这次我们想换一个思路，我们想在交互的形式上去
做花样，尤其是其实玩家其实更关注我们的角色能做哪些事情。Are
they gonna finally make Geo better？
在比如说1.6的版本，我们有一个新增的玩法叫浪船，对吧？然后在3.6版本，我们做
OK，I don't think that's what they're hinting towards. I think
族群，那么他们有一位叫斯路莎的勇者，对吧？那他其实也会有一些独特的移动方式。Yeah,
damn. For a second there, I thought they were gonna say like we're gonna improve the elements of reactions and to make crystallize not shit.
角色自己的行为模式里，对，那其实大家在4.8和4.7这两个版本前瞻的彩蛋里面也看到了一些端倪，就是包括我们展出的这三位角色，他们都会有各自不同的移动方式。
啊，我理解了，就是说我们
角色的这个移动能力是不是要得到空前的这个变化？对，其实你看，就是之前我也看到过有旅行者在社群里面有说到，那这次我们是不是可以有一些飞檐走壁的这样的行为模式嘛？那大家也都在视频当中也有看到，我们确实是在做这样的尝试。哎，我看到还有玩家问到啊，说那个前瞻彩蛋里面那个马纳尼
What's that gonna be about?
Is that just exclusive just to her? 其实我觉得就是硬要说的话，它其实是算技能，但是我觉得呢，就像刚才我说的，Damn,
Farina got power creep to real hard there.
的行为模式是融入到它的方方面面的，对它作为一个技能。Like
girl can walk across the water at all times, but meanwhile, Mualani can just surf across it all the way.
他应该是伙伴才对。对，应该是伙伴。这个我感觉我已经感受到了啊。那么我们问完这个第一个问题，我感觉鸡哥还可以啊，鸡哥还可以游刃有余啊。那我们再看看是不是要提供一点更难的问题啊？
还有更难的吗？
又是一个彩蛋掉落啊！让我们来看第二段 VCR。
The second VCR. Oh, these like fans asking like questions. Yes, can we fly with them? Also, I love this guy's shirt.
それとナタのキャラクターって独自の探索システムとかは持っているんでしょうか？よければたっぷり教えてください。
也是一位我们的老朋友。
这一位其实我也看过，好像是叫
金枪鱼头。
对，金枪鱼头，对对对对。
凯亚系列攻略我很喜欢。
然后，
其实召唤他也特别喜欢。
Oh, he's a consecrator. Okay.
那其实他刚才也有提到说，龙的探索机制是如何设计的？
对。
他提到说，在我们 PV 的末尾是有一个飞行的龙。
Yeah, please tell me we get to ride on the birds like freaking dragons.
因为可能
透
今天是干货，
那其实就是包括这条飞行的龙在内啊，纳塔所有的玩家看到的这种不同形态的龙，他们各自都会有一套独特的探索机制。那这个探索机制呢，和刚才这个问题里面我们提及的，包括纳塔的角色，他们之间也会有一些息息相关的设计点。大家肯定会有疑问说，之前在视频里看到说我们好像可以操作这些龙，进行探索，那到底是我们通过某种方式驯化了这条龙，还是说我们把自己放到这个龙
？I hope not. I hope not placing ourselves inside the animals.
我想说的是，我们其实提供了一种类似
we offered an indwelling mechanic
这样的一个机制。
附身。
对，可以让旅行者在纳塔的领域去。
Okay, so we can temporarily become them.
获得这些龙的操作权。那不同的龙，当然它也会精通不同的。
Yo, holy shit!
探索的一些本领。
对对对。
Traversal in fucking Natlan is gonna be sick.
纳塔之后啊，我们是可以真飞檐走壁，对吧？
对，没错，没错。那还是回归到刚才金枪鱼头提到的那个。
Please give us a creature that can like wall climb really quick.
可能，我只能说，大家可以敬请期待，纳塔后续版本里面我们。
Look forward to 5.1 when we introduce a dragon that can fly on.
我一定要抽一个给小罗号啊，对吧？不能让小罗号闲着啊。我们在做问卷调查的时候啊，有超过三成的玩家提到我们整个纳塔的这个世界观啊，就是大家都想了解，比如说纳塔的这个设计这个灵感是从哪里来啊
？And more importantly, why is there no Natlan or anywhere else?
包括觉得纳塔也是一个这种人龙共生的这么一个国家，所以想请小龙号跟我们讲讲在这个纳塔啊，我们这个人和龙之间到底是一个什么样的这个共生关系啊？
我们知道就是纳塔的龙啊，被纳塔人视为
So they're just kind of chilling in the cities as well.
对，说一个可能不是很恰当的比喻。
Oh my god, these guys look so adorable.
猫猫狗狗一样。
Is that a rabbit?
其实就是纳塔人的伙伴。
And yeah, that guy looks like a freaking bishop, but friendly.
有机会，但我也很想，他们在一起生活，在一起工作、战斗，彼此信任呢，也彼此照顾。虽然纳塔的人和龙伙伴之间可能没有办法直接用语言相通，但是长久的相处呢，也能够让他们能够弄懂彼此的心思和一些就是习惯了。
对。
那么我们旅行者在拜访各个不同部族的时候呢，就可以发现纳塔人和龙伙伴相处的方式可能也会有些不一样。就比如说在我们应该第一个接触的部落回声之子中，稳重可靠的疾风龙伙伴呢，会帮助他们的部族成员挖掘宝石和矿物，或者呢在山洞当中去开辟通路。
He can mine rewards for me。
感觉很有用。
对，然后同时呢，他们的爪子和那个钻角呢，就很需要就是人类伙伴的照顾了。那这个地方我也就简单的先抛一抛，因为我们 5.0 会接触到这三个部族的龙伙伴，然后在之后的环节当中，我们会有专门的同学来给大家进行更详细的演绎。
对，
这里我就先小卖一个关子。
Okay, so each tribe has its own like, I guess, Saurian.
对，我听完小龙的介
绍，觉
得这个纳塔啊，人和龙是一种非常和谐共生啊，而且是非常友爱。
I'm assuming yeah, those three animals we saw are going to be playable, and then maybe the bird and the other ones will be playable in like 5.1 or something.
特殊问题，我们来看 VCR。
Oh, Tuanto, yo!
What's up, guys? I'm Tuanto, and I'm here to ask some questions for the Genshin team regarding 5.0. Pyro's the spotlighted element for the new update, specifically for Natlan, and I'm curious, how does Pyro have a significance in Natlan?
Okay, that's 100% scripted, I gotta say.
Newer players in the game, because I do know that a lot of newer players have difficulties and or struggle to get to the newer pieces of content that get added.
I like that you're doing this, so actually like speaking to the community themselves.
I want to give you guys all my luck, because if I can't win the 50-50, I hope at the very least, you can. And I hope you find your own true meaning on your own journey.
Oh, that's sweet, Wato. If I lose 50-50, I'm coming to your house and demanding a refund. Nah, I love him. I love Wato. Although Tuanta would actually speak, I don't know, he'd say something like, how big is Mavuika's cheeks or something. Wait, no, that's Zyox I'm thinking about, Zyox, not Tuanto. Also, yeah, the question he asked was, like, I'm curious too, because there's not a lot of pyro characters in Natlan, it seems. It seems like the only new pyro character we're getting is Yansan and Mavuika, and that's it. The sacred flame. I think Yansan's Electro? Oh shoot, well then Mavuika's the only one then.
之所以说纳塔是战争的国度, 是因为纳塔在历史上,
which is kind of weird, honestly, because in... When Inazuma came out, we got a swarm of electric characters. Sumeru, we got a swarm of dendro characters. Same with Fontaine. Yet for Natlan, we only get one pyro character. It's kind of weird.
那他们在这种战斗和战争中留下的英勇事迹呢，就被记录下来， 在黑曜史上刻写成为...
Maybe the game is just like, hey, you have enough pyro characters already. I'm here if Arlecchino, if Yoimiya, D-Look and whatnot. Aren't you satisfied?
那么一代又一代的纳塔人呢，在古民的引导下不断的成长， 不断的去战斗和过去那些 他们历史上的英雄们一样用自己的力量支撑着纳塔在一个巨大的威胁之下屹立不倒。 那么到了如今呢，六大部族之间依然会彼此竞争，在圣火竞技场所举办的大赛中比拼各项的能力，从而选拔出最为强大的战士，继续向着战场去进发。对，所以就是说纳塔的这个战争并不是我们理解的那个战争，而是竞技，对吧？其实。
Okay, so the stuff of war is actually about competition, okay. Yo,
Jessica!
I think she's the character I'm most hyped for, aside from the Pyro Archon, of course. In essence, she's Genshin's Himiko. Oh my god, look at the way her hair flows and everything. Also, I do wonder, just a lore, what happened to the previous Pyro Archon? Did Mavuika like beat her in a duel or something? Like, Also, yes, please do reveal the Pyro Traveler, and please don't make them shit like the Hydro Traveler.
那至于他的性格，我觉得大家很快就能够体会到他所拥有的那种和他的力量相匹配的那种。Her
queen-like confidence matching her power.
对对，我印象特别深刻，因为我看我们娜塔前传短片的时候。I
mean, I think we got that much from just the trailer alone.
走出来之后，充满了这个自信啊。对对对。前面聊了这么多啊，我看我们还有。GC
says I would like a grand spectacle.
那也请两位来一起来看看。안녕하세요,
쌤입니다. 오늘은 원신 팀에게 5.0 버전과 관련된 몇 가지 질문을 드릴 건데요.
I'm guessing these are all Genshin content creators that are like asking questions here.
혹시 원신 세계관에 이미 죽은 누군가가 부활하다는 뜻 아니겠죠? 아 그리고 우인 날씨만 카피타노 두꺼운 톡으로 쓰고 있는데 설마 나타의 무더운 날씨에 기절해 버리는 건 아닐까 싶습니다.
I think that's one thing people have been talking about as well. The resurrection part. People think Signora will get revived in Natlan or something.
说到特定角色复活这一点，我可能说的远一些，就是战争的国度嘛，它必然会伴随着牺牲，那死亡从来都无法被轻易逆转。但是呢，在纳塔唯独在纳塔，我们英雄们的火焰不太会轻易的熄灭。 就我们足迹批语里面说到戴英说过一句谜语嘛，就败者成为战火的余烬而胜者重燃。
对，
那在纳塔牺牲是无法阻拦英雄们奋战的脚步的，他们是有机会去继续战斗，直到那一场战争彻底的终结。那至于是怎样的一个重燃的这个机制，不要卖一个关子，因为这个就是我们可能纳塔的剧情里面一个很
so the character from the dead might come back to life。
每次到这种时候我其实是最难受的那一个。
Maybe the senior remains won't be on copium after all。 Maybe
队长其实在纳塔的整个主线剧情当中也扮演了一个非常重要的角色。对，那刚才小罗浩所说到的重燃包括战争这些概念，某种意义上也是队长来到这片土地的原因。对对，那刚才至于刚才那个比较
不能说太多了。
至于
don't spoil everything, no, don't leak everything, no。
中暑，那我可能再剧透一下，就是可能
I mean he won't die of heat stroke, he has a cryo vision, so
不太可能会
he'll be fine, right?
我感觉我已经 get 到一些信息了啊。那个既然两位都说到了这个火神与队长啊，那么我们纳塔的其他新角色是不是也该登场了？
那是
哦，对哦。
Are the new characters?
没有讲到
角色。Yeah, please talk about the characters, please.
先看一段短片。
Whoa, skateboarding. What does this have to do with Genshin? We're selling all new Genshin Impact skateboards, so you can finally go outside and touch grass. Oh, okay. What a transition. Okay. Dude, you can surf everywhere with a fucking Mualani shark? You can surf in the sky? Yo. Okay, I guess I'm showing off Mualani first. Are these like the real life Genshin ads that they're doing? Oh no, the cat's gonna be run over. Okay, are you? Not the most creative way to do these ads, but I appreciate trying to do something different. Oh god, what are they gonna do for Kinich? Oh no. He's gonna teleport up there with the power of a pixelated being and Dendro. Oh, the kite just exploded. Okay, Hoyo, we get it. These are the new characters coming out. We knew that already. I can already sense people cringing at these ads already. Oh, hey, redemption code. I forgot these were a thing. Hey, first redeem code, everybody. Claim it. Yeah, claim it fast. Oh, expire in 30 days. Okay, well, at least that's a longer time for the redemption code. Let me go ahead and just put that in chat real quick, just so you guys can copy and paste. Do. This sounds like Legend of Zelda music, honestly. I like it. Although, it will probably say the Gen- It will still say to the Zelda fans, I'm like, yeah, Genshin is still a Zelda ripoff. Yeah. Also, damn, look at this art, though. Yo. Everybody's here, except Xylonen, for some reason. I'm not sure to say her name. Xylonen? I don't know. But yeah, the leopard lady is not here, for some reason. Also, Sit Lolly is not here either. I'm guessing maybe she'll be more relevant in 5.1, I mean.
女性们，欢迎回来。那到这里呢，节目组交给我的任务呢，已经圆满完成了。
到这就结束了吗？
接下来啊，我们就把现场交给项目组的同学们了。有两位啊，为大家介绍 5.0 版本的新角色和新剧情。我呢，就提前下班了。
这样的吗？那
好介绍。
这什么情况？
那我俩来呗。
那我换个姿势啊，我换个姿势。
那既然聊到旅行者们最关心的角色，那还是
继续。Dawe is just taking a break now.
先来。
OK. 好，那刚才我们聊到的时候也说到呢，在纳塔的六个部族当中，他们有一些身怀绝技的各个部族的勇士。那么这三位角色也是来自于不同的三个部族的勇士。
OK.
在纳塔的魔神任务中。
Oh, yep. Archon Quest Act One and Act Two available. OK.
可以和这三位勇士一同参与到在圣火竞技场。
Not the same thing with Cimmerian and Fontaine, right? Both acts being available at the 5.0 update, I think.
三位勇士当中，可能有一位小姑娘了，她可能不太敢啊，这么认可自己。
OK， 我知道你在说哪一位了，那就是在之前。
Probably two archons.
节目当中。
Oh yeah, probably the previous archon's name Marada. Yo, Kachina.
对吧？
卡奇娜是货真价实的回声之子的古名持有者。
Oh God, story spoilers.
乌沙伯蒂。
乌沙伯蒂。
哎，意思是坚强。
Her ancient name is 乌沙伯蒂。Oh, okay.
会被赐予这个伟大的名字，因为有很多。
So, I guess each character has a real name and an ancient name.
都曾经持有这个名字，但是他认为，既然得到了这个殊荣，他就有义务参与这个在圣火竞技场举行的归火盛宴巡礼。虽然他一直。
Also, yeah, did you guys catch her rarity or. Like, yeah, she's a 4-star, right? I think so. Yo, she's a drill machine. Yep, she's Geo. And apparently she can like climb mountains with that thing she has. Like climb straight up walls.
Yup.
Oh, she can even use it on the ground, okay. Yeah, it seems like they're going for like easier traversal overall for Natlan. That seems like a fun skill to use. Oh, she can also just leave it down and just have it be a turret? Cool. Oh, and it counts as a construct too. Alright. Klee passive. That is going to be very useful.
Oh, 特产雷达。
没错，而且他在去和纳塔的一部分采集物交互的时候呢，还会去恢复全队的体力。
这也算是四星角色里面他就特别能够帮助我们。
I think she's like probably the first character to like restore stamina, right?
旅行者们呢，在纳塔的魔神任务，也就是融化与炎热。
Oh, you get it for free as well. Nice.
开始后不久就会遇到卡奇娜。
啊。
那
just by doing the story, you just get her.
加入
到主角的冒险队伍。
Nice. Okay.
那我们说了这么多。
Yep, free 4-star character.
传闻啊，那接下来我们要介绍的。
Mualani, yo, I love her design so much.
用卡奇娜她自己的话来说，在遇到马达尼之前啊，她都。
So I love that her hair just kind of like bunny ears in a sense.
那作为流泉之众的成员呢，马达尼她酷爱各类水上运动。
Oh, damn, she playing the fucking maracas. Not maracas, whatever those are.
比起自己玩的开心，她更享受和大家一起度过美妙的时光。无论是她作为水上用品商店的店主呢，还是她作为一个新生代的向导当中的一个佼佼者呀，马达尼她都非常热心于和他人推荐一段。
I'm going to be pulling for her 100%. Oh, she has a story quest too, and I'm guessing Kinich will as well. I just realized her eyes are like shaped like fish as well. That's super adorable. Okay, she's a catalyst user. Same with Barbara Kokomi and somebody else, I'm forgetting. Mona. Is she throwing freaking water balloons at the enemy? Yo, she can just run them over, let's go! What the hell did she just throw out? A fucking. Is that a water balloon that just came out of her? Oh my god, you can just run over the enemy multiple times? Yeah, what is that? Like an octopus or something that's coming out?
对，没错。 得到更大的优势。
对。
Oh, that's our burst as well. Cool.
发射一个巨大的沙沙导弹啊，迸射出一个非常绚丽的涂鸦。
Oh wait, she can activate it mid air too.
涂鸦性质的这样的一些表现。
I think that's what it was.
敌人能够充分感受到来自。
Oh, hopefully, it doesn't look sick.
这样一种水上运动的精神。然后刚才说到了马拉尼的一些作战能力啊，那其实除了在战斗当中，在敌人之间进行穿梭以外呢，这个沙沙冲浪板的这个状态，
哦 ，OK，
马拉尼在一些特殊的地方，自由的穿梭。
So she specifically will have special traversal effects around Fontaine, Natlan.
能力，也就是她也可以在小地图当中去显示。
Oh, she also has a specialty tracker. OK.
哇，那不愧是我们流泉之中最好的向导呀！她的移动方式又很特别，然后又很灵活，而且还能帮助我们去探索大世界。
除此之外，她还有一些别的能力，也就是说。他在纳塔这些存在燃素，刚才我们有提到燃素这个概念啊，就在燃素机制的区域里面和一部分的采集物进行交互呢，他还可以去恢复整个队伍的燃素值。
那三位勇士中的最后一位，则是来自我们
Kinich
年轻猎龙人，他名字叫基尼奇。
基尼奇，
他看起来虽然有些沉默寡言，
yep, Dendro Shao, as many people call him.
生活的经验赋予他制服各种野。
Yo, that parkour ability looks freaking sick. Like, I wonder, are these parkour abilities gonna be locked to just these characters, or can anybody just use them?
这个部落里有不少的部落成员都喜欢挑战极限，对，然后他们的实力肯定也不同凡响。那他们这么强大，是不是有什么独家秘诀？比如说，我注意到基尼奇好像不是孤军作战，对他身边其实有一个很奇怪的，算是生物吗？有一个很奇怪的龙伙伴，对，那个这个伙伴是为他在战斗中。
What's the lore significance of Ajar being like
that
pixelated thing？
酷酷的阿乔，我们大家都称呼他阿乔吧，和基尼奇是几乎形影不离的。
阿乔，我感觉他的画风跟其他人不太一样啊。那你说长相这样
，He's punching him in the face and shaking his damn ass。
感觉也很奇怪，我感觉他在之前的影片里面体现出来的那个感觉是挺狂妄自大的。
确实，就是阿乔和基尼奇可以说是完全不一样的性格。阿乔的性格特别恶劣，而且大部分时间他都在和基尼奇斗嘴。
Yep, like Naruto and Sasuke.
也会为基尼奇他自己招式的一些非议。但好像来说，就是
But yeah, he's not like a classical dragon. He's just like weirdly pixelated for some reason.
他是一个怎么说呢？意志很坚定，目标很清晰。他就是完成自己的委托，然后去向委托人。
Dude, his eyes look very pretty. Holy shit.
而更多关于基尼奇
Yep, but he has a sword quest too. Yep.
继承的古名的秘文呢？旅行者们
The Secret of Time, the ancient name he has.
然后得到进一步的解答。
I also love the jacket that he's like wearing around his waist as well. That's very cool.
战斗技能了，那大家也看到了，他是一个擅长极限运动的这样的一个少年。
Oh, you can just keep mid air the whole time with him.
用类似的技能，通过元素战技。
Oh, you can also latch onto enemies as well.
除此以外
，while shooting at them.
接到敌人之后呢，还会发动一些
Yo.
特殊的攻击，并且在
Wait, you can fight these things? I thought they were friends.
很厉害的，像手炮一样的。这样的一个技能叫做
he can just oh my god he can just do that the whole time just grab on one enemy and just run circles around them that's actually kind of sick oh yeah and Aja just oh, he actually becomes a large ass dragon okay you want I changed my mind I'm getting them both
你大概会猜到基尼奇在纳塔的大地上也会具备什么样的能力
哇这也太好了吧就是我们
that's such a cool fucking ultimate holy shit
收集纳塔的特产。
没错，因为基尼奇他也有显示纳塔区域特展的能力。
Wait, they all three have the same ability?
玄牧人部族成员的能力，也就是他和部分的采集物交互的时候，还可以去提升队伍中的所有的移动速度。
Oh, but yeah, they also have the side effect of.
就预见到，就他能够加入玩家的队伍，成为大家的助力了。这三位角色身上会有特殊的纹路和怎么说特效，很有一些纳塔的风格，就像周身有火焰在燃烧一样的感觉。
那这种设计呢，其实也是我们在
纳
塔身上所尝试的一种新机制。
They have auras。
机制和纳塔本土的一些世界观结合起来，称呼之为夜魂加持。
Night Soul Blessing。
利用这种叫夜魂加持的状态，在战斗中充分发挥它的作用。
Okay, so this exclusive to Natlan characters. Okay。
我们被称为一种叫做燃素刻录的仪式来激发的，借助一种古老的仪式啊，在纳塔地区神之眼的持有者。 不仅可以与部族的大灵和地脉进行沟通，还能通过这个仪式强化自己的实力。
OK， 这个大灵听起来好像是什么部族的监
视。Oh, these are biomes.
图腾和信仰这样的。
Hydro, Dendro, and Geoversion. Hmm, kind of like our characters.
概念的加入会导致纳塔会有一些完全不一样的体验。
对，
那我们作为设计者呢，其实也对这些体验做了一些便利性的设计。那我们从 5.0 开始重新制作了一部分且试身手的活动场地。那大家可以看到，就且试身手的场地会变成一个完全是纳塔风格的，类似大世界这样的。
Oh, cool. So I guess the test runs aren't just locked to certain domains anymore.
方便的去测试角色的各项能力啊，进行更深度的游玩和体验。我知道肯定介绍完这三个角色之后，那大家也会再问一个问题，那旅行者在每个国家只要他触碰一下，其实
Yes, showcase the pyro traveler
这个国家的相关元素的对这个能力，那么在纳塔他是不是也能够很顺利的去接触到火元素的能力，并且也和这些角色一样有夜魂加持的效果呢？
哎，提到这个就要提前和大家说明一下了，那么这次旅行者来到纳塔和七天神像进行初次共鸣的时候呢，由于某种不知名的原因
Due to some unknown reason
并不能立刻唤醒火元素力。
哦，
这个奇怪的现象其实涉及到了我们现在纳塔面临。
Oh, so there's no pyro traveler in 5.0.
我们在纳塔的旅程进一步深入的时候就能够得到详细的解答了。
Okay. So, damn, we're just not getting Pyro Traveler yet, I guess. Damn, okay. So, no Pyro Traveler in
5.0.
I guess they're just trying to improve his kit before they release him like shit. Instead of making him bad, they just skipped him. Yo, Jaska! My wife. God, her design looks so cool.
在 5.0 版本的魔神任务当中呢，他也会和我们一起参与到某项重要的调查之中。还有刚才提到的来自于沃路之邦的我们的健身教练、潜规火盛宴巡礼冠军导师伊安山。
哎呀 ，Of course, 伊安山。
当中为旅行者提供帮助。
那其实刚才在问答环节中啊，大家其实也反复提及的就是
火神还有
还有愚人众的第一席队长，就实力最强劲的这一位。那么他们都会在魔神任务中登场吗？
对。
Yep.
也挺期待，就
Please support the showdown. Yep, capitano versus mavuika. They're gonna like blow up the fucking arena with their duel. Yeah, where are they at? These characters, Auroran as well. Yeah. Oh, in future versions. Okay, so they're not here yet. That's okay. Not everyone needs to be revealed in one update. Let them cook. Oh, here we go. Banners.Mualani and Kazuha, okay, first banners, yes, gonna be pulling on Mualani 100%. And Kachina's here too, nice. And then Kinich and Ryan Shogun, ooh. Damn.
此外呢，全新
Is Kinich gonna get cocked here?
和五星法器冲浪之光也将出现在武器活动
中。That's your catalyst.
纳塔地区也新增了五
把。Oh yeah, of course we got new Natlan craftables as well. They look cool looking.
阿龙进行兑换。
那在接下来的前瞻的一系列的活动当中，我们会推出一个。
I wonder though. A lot of people want Ryan Shogun.
H5 网页活动。那参与这个网页活动呢，旅行者不但能够直观的了解到即将上线的五点零版本的新内容。还能在版本更新后直接通过这个
We will just get the
三种纳塔地区的
the craft of weapons for free? Just by doing that event? Okay.
关注官方后续的公告，了解更多的活动详情。那
That seems nice.
全新的武器以外
Damn.
五点零版本更新以后啊
Of course, new artifact sets. Can't forget about those.
他们叫做进城勇者会卷
Obsidian Codex and Scroll of the Heroes of Cinder City. I'm assuming they're
那旅行者们也可以在纳塔挑战全新的铸圣秘境，来获取这两套圣遗物。
I guess we'll see what they do.
我一口气讲了这么多，应该没有漏掉什么吧？我觉得。
那就是我们的新角色，然后我们的新武器，还有圣遗物的部分，也就到此为止告一段落了。
嗯，没错。
那么我也圆满完成了今天的任务
啊，
那我也要、
啊、
追随大伟哥。
Now's my turn to take a break.
大伟哥今天台上就只剩我一个人了吗？
你可以自己想办法呀。
哦，我自己想办法吗？好。
Damn.
那我就先
accept reality.
让我的小伙伴们来现场来撑撑面子。嗯，行，那请大家拭目以待。
This must be your first time in Natlan. Chief says Natlan's a little different from other nations.Because we live in separate
Whoa, times, why is the frame rate so slow on this?
But every time the pilgrimage
okay, never mind, it's just a fire that was really slow.
Gather at the stadium to compete and find the strongest warriors. See those people with the tapetlosaurs?
Those are our enemies and we have to kill them.
I come from the Children of Echoes.
Children of Echoes, okay, so I guess it's the different tribes.
The tapetlosaurs are our friends and co-workers too.They help us find the prettiest ores and gems. And that means my tribe has all the best jewelers. When we find a really special gemstone, we use it to...
Himiko's already dead, Demises.
Oh, also,
no, he's not. She's very much alive here. Don't say that, man.
Super fun. Anyway, the other contestants...
Damn, look at them breakdancing.
That's right. We live alongside the...
Okay, so that's Mualani's tribe.
Our tribe is a really awesome vacation spot. Oh, sorry. Got lost in the music for a sec. The people of my tribe love getting together to go fishing, listen to music, and relax.
Damn, this looks like a surf sup club or something.
Favorite thing oh. is bathing in the hot springs. The Koholosaurs like it too.
That's oh, damn.
Such good pals.But make sure you give him
some hey guys, hey Hoyo, when are you gonna release a shirtless male character? Like, come on. We want the muscle mans out there. The tribe of himbos here. Line of liners was here, he's gonna hang out there all the time. Okay, so Kini's tribe, probably.
We've got a lot of messengers.Everything from letters to packages. Being quick on our feet is one of our strengths.
Oh, is that Kinich talking right now?
Who take on a wide range of commissions.
Ha! Look! Those idiots have a bigger death wish than you!
Oh, and that's Aja, okay. I expected Kinich should be a bit deeper or more edgy sounding like Xiao, honestly.
This region is inhospitable. Young people from my tribe come here because they like a challenge. Next up, there's...
Wait. Look, the competition's starting.
Next time, then.
Next time, figure end game. I guess I'm irrelevant.
I can't wait to find out.
Nice. Up, oh, and that's your second redemption code, folks. All right. Let me just go ahead and just key it in chat here. 7SMTG. Okay.Okay, yeah, this life is looking pretty good so far. I'm definitely gonna be pulling for probably both Kinich and Mualani. Aw, man. Kachina seems pretty fun, too. This update's gonna be great, I can already tell. I'm kinda glad Mualani's coming first, because out of these three, I think she's the one I want to play the most.Also, damn, this Natlan music sounds really, really freaking fire. No pun intended, obviously, but damn. I'm guessing the other characters are from different tribes too, probably. What the fuck?
Hey.好各位旅行者欢迎回来
Man, you guys have the hoodies already for the creatures? Come on, sell them already.
那我的小伙伴现在也已经到场了那他们到底是人还是龙啊哎说你们呢别睡了别睡了别睡了节目都开始了
睡得真香啊
机会难得你们给大家介绍一下你们自己
大家好我是疾风龙啊不对我是原神的战斗设计师老杨平时的主要工作呢主要是做龙然后今天呢，很高兴能到现场给大家亲自做一次龙。
哎，大家好。
I guess I hear the yeah, just explain the story in gameplay.
很荣幸呢，这次能够和大家介绍一下纳塔的场景和关卡设计理念。
欢迎两位。好， 那今天啊，我们请到小巴还有老杨来到现场呢，其实是我们接着刚才的话题继续聊。我们已经知道了呀，就纳塔是一个人和龙共生的国度。那刚才其实我们在之前的介绍里也有谈到说，哎，纳塔的地貌环境啊，其实也跟其他的国家非常的不一样。
Right, significantly different.
看到了很多这样的评论。对于我们开发者来讲呢，纳塔
New area, land of vibrant stone and flaming springs. I'm guessing that's like our main hub and whatnot, right? 比如
说旅行者可以在巨大的山体上面看到多
彩
的图样，或者是说在各个部落里面看到很多潮酷的要素。
Damn, all this graffiti looks sick, actually.
就是老杨，你怀里抱的这是个什么？
这应该是我们纳塔会随时陪着我们。
Because they already created plushies of these things.
小伙伴，就是在纳塔，我们已经知道它是一个人和龙结合的国度，所以我们整个的设计理念是围绕着人和龙怎么做的结合。
没错，那上一趴我也有说到啊，就是旅行者可以通过一种附身的方式来附到纳塔的龙类身上，从而进行一些复杂的探索的行为。
Right? Can we also use him in combat? That's my question. Can I use him to trample over hill trolls?
旅行者们在纳塔探险的时候就会遇到这一只特别的小疾风龙。
we get our little Pokemon. Yay!
它会陪伴我们经历很多有趣的小故事，并且也会参与到重要的世界任务当中哦。
Okay, he's actually looks very adorable. Actually, I want to keep him.
刚才你也有谈到，纳塔有非常多的部落的特色。那其实今天也很难得，我们有三个小龙人在场，对吧？不如这次我们就眼见为实，带着玩家去逛一圈。
好呀，
可以啊，来来来，我们先去我们疾风龙的部落去看一下我的老家。
走走走，跟着他，
走吧。
这里啊，就是我们回声之子的部落。
哦。
大家可以看到啊，我们这个地方有很多的宝石。
Oh, ores, yes, give them to me. I need to craft all the weapons I can.
看起来就跟岩元素很有关系。
那已经是他们了，已经
代入了。
是的，我们回声之子啊，一直觉得最强的战士，比如说像我这样的，才能够获得最好的宝石。所以呢，我们去深耕了一下挖掘相关的一些技术。
我来为老杨补充一下，就是在回声之子周围呢，也有不少因为钻探和挖掘而被发现的奇特景观，比如这处巨大的含有大量固态燃素的鎏金之脉，以及一些很神秘的可以一直向下挖掘的
More caves. That's something not as complicated as the desert caves.
你刚才也说
I hope not.
对吧？你们部落是以宝石和挖掘做建长的，那你们的战斗伙伴也就是疾风龙，想必也非常擅长这个领域的一些能力吧。
疾风龙虽然在地面上移动看起来憨态，
Yo, look at him go.
但是借助燃素它可以在地下快速的移动，还能翻山越岭。
Yo, he fucking moving. Oh, he can even crawl walls too. 探查
地下什么地方有宝石。
Damn, nice.
他应该是你们这个部落的跑酷好手了。
哎，是的。
哎，你看，小巴那边还有一处，好像是你们部落的。
是的，这是我的老家。接下来不如到我的老家去看一下吧。
没问题，那你来带路。
哇，这里呢就是我的老家西游龙部族。流泉之
中 The Koholasaurus.
That's what
they're called, okay.
然后以及喜欢泡泡温泉休闲放松，然后包括他们的伙伴企鹅。
Oh my god, they look so cute.
也是一副懒散甚至
They somewhat look like bishops, but friendly appearing. And you know, not trying to kill us.
但当遇到真正的战斗以及比赛的时候，也都是一把好手。值得一提的是呢，咱部族的人也是纳塔少数的能够在液态燃素区域上活动的人。
液态燃素是不是就是那种看起来特别像岩浆的那种区域？
对对对，我记得，因为之前我们也提到过液态燃素。那小巴给我们再介绍一下。
好的啊，液态燃素区域呢是，我们看起来是比较像橙红色，很热，甚至有一点。
Flowers growing near the lava? Damn.
哎，那既然它这么危险的话，是不是我在周边游玩的时候要特别小心才行？
Yeah, will I burn it up if I just jump in there? Oh, wait, they swim in lava, right?
We two 都说差不多了，鸡哥觉得缺点什么？
那接下来就去看看我的老家，也就是灭龙的部族怎么样。
And the last creature.
我来带路。
The,
嘿嘿，这可是灭龙部族。
I don't know what you call those.
哎，既然大家看到了聂龙部族这边有一个这么大的聂
龙部族，The Yunkasaurus。
可以啊，看一下跟我们疾风龙还有。
Okay, I'm not gonna remember all these names.
没问题。
That's
actually, they're all dinosaurs. Their own aspects.
Boom!
Oh, you can attack enemies using them.
去释放它们，造成爆炸的效果。Cool. 这种火流果胶呢，它不仅能够作为觅食的手段。 在其他的时段里面，它还可以作为孽龙在山峦之间来回穿梭的这样的一个媒介。那既然孽龙这么厉害，它们部族的人呢？哎，那么这不得不说，孽龙部族叫玄木人，所有的部族。
It looks like this just started to kind of like just live in the trees, or just like the upper levels of the cliffs.
孽龙部族，也就是玄木人部族的成员，他们多半呀，也都成为了冒险家、运动员，或者说快递员这样的一些职业。
哇，这是fucking sheep。旁边呢，其实有这么一个遍布高耸悬崖的遗迹，主营庙宇。和猎龙一起呢，旅行者说不定可以找到神秘的宝藏哦。鸡哥呀，我还是非常在意刚才说的吃果子这个事儿。我听过一个关于你们猎龙的八卦，不知道你听过没有？我感觉不是什么好八卦。我听说有一只猎龙平时不是很自律。
然后呢，因为吃了太多的果子，导致身材发福。哦，no，we're gonna fight Nemonchosaurus。鸡哥，你可一定得保重啊！啊，原来是这么一回事。那我觉得呀，这里面可有太多的新闻，你不知道了。所以老杨，我们不如我们坐回去，就这件事情，我跟你们再好好说道说道。好。哎，老杨，就接着刚才那个孽龙的话题啊，我觉得我必须要为他说句公道话。
虽然这是聂龙，他又贪吃。Oh, he's a boss. Okay. Gluttonous. Oh my God, he's so fat. Holy shit. Holy shit. Okay. Big boy right here. Wait, are those birds? They look like birds. I don't know.
那一定没有这个意思。Okay,
so he's definitely the boss for Kinich, right?
那我还不得不说一句啊，这个孽龙的 boss 长上去还是挺可爱的。难道我们纳塔就全都是这种可爱画风的龙吗？就像我们三个一样。啊，那肯定不止。Oh,
Godflame, Tyrant. I'm not trying to say that middle word.
会飞的大龙。
Cucasaur or something.
这个也是我们 5.0 版本旅行者需要面对的一个敌人。
I'm guessing this is the boss for Mualani? Maybe? I don't know.
Because
they look like they're fire. Yo, you can just surf away from them? What the? Oh, he can just be. Okay. That's gonna be an annoying attack.
我们在纳塔的旅程中还有许多神奇的生物，比如说看上去就很容易被撞飞的鸟。
Dude, yeah, they seem like they went out of all out with the freaking wildlife for this
update。还有一些看上去就很会飞的老鼠。除了刚才老杨讲到的这些奇特生物以外呢，在纳塔还有很多风格迥异的场景，比如说神秘的高兰。Yeah,
what is this place?
还有巨大的间歇喷发的火山。未来呢？
Oh, that's a volcano. We can actually go there? Oh, no, in future versions.
大家知道，我们在每个国家推出的时候，都会有一套叫声望系统的内容。
Yep, reputation system's back, of course.
那我们对这个声望系统做了一次全新的尝试。And
we're also gonna get the Natlan glider, probably.
各个部落的一个叫钥匙图腾柱的地方，去接取对应部族的讨伐悬赏和务虚通告。哎，那
Tribe Chronicles
还是声望系统吗？七哥，你别骗我。啊，对，我好像说到这里，感觉。So
we actually have to do like story quests in order to unlock the reputation system?
漏了一点。 在之前的环节当中，我有提到一个叫部族祭文的概念。那么在钥匙图腾柱这里，旅行者们还可以开启。Oh,
there's one per tribe.
这个祭文呢，除了包含部族的传说、
Wait, is that right?
周边的风土人情以外，还有大家最关心的纳塔的角色传说任务。哦，也就是说，包含上述所有的内容在内，每一个部族都将陆续开放三个章节供玩家游玩。所以，我们纳塔的传说任务其实是换了一种新的形式出现的。
除了部落巨文以外呢，在 5.0 版本还有更多以单元剧情式出现的、
okay,
篇幅比较短的世界任务，比方说刚才介绍到的以小家伙为。
I do not want to be taken for the R&R ride again. No thanks. One time was enough.
包括场景呀，包括我们战斗的一些 boss 呀，包括刚才说的任务。那么接下来我们再跟旅行者们介绍一下这次 5.0
版本。Up and events, here we go.
Probably
gonna be like an introduction event and whatnot. Take Traces of Artistry, Thorns of Crowns, Land of Overflows back. Dodoko's bombastic escapes. God damn, we gotta escape from Klee.
值得一提的是，其实旅行者们已经游玩过的一些挑战呢，在纳塔也会以一个完全不同的形式呈现。这里我要替他说一句，我们也为旅行者准备了一些特殊的游玩的短片。哦，具体有多不一样，我们一起看一下就知道了。好，那我们就看一看。好。
这次呢，我们纳塔呢带来很多全新的玩法。今天也邀请了几个朋友到现场来实际体验一下。我就现在
brought a security card
这个地方有一个龙灵，这是疾风龙部落的。然后我们可以回复到这个龙灵上。Okay,
so it's... okay, so certain challenges with certain certain creatures.
在这个过程里面呢，我们
judging from the previous experiences, I'll make us turn off the volcano. I hope not. I hope the volcano stays there.
多的吃到金币。
Okay, pretty straightforward time trial. And you're dead. Damn.
咱们教学也
just killed him.
立刻进入比赛怎么样？来吧，实战环节。咱两组队互相比一下挑战用时和挑战得分。
We can actually compete with your friends with certain time challenges.
我上来就漏了。Actually,
no, I don't think that's it. I still find it weird that yeah, we're not getting a pyro traveler immediately.
哎，你要相信我，你转头看看呗，你漏不了。
There's probably some lore implications as to like why that's the case, probably. At least I'm assuming they're doing it for lore reasons and not because Pyro Traveler isn't ready yet.
来来来，赶紧。哎，等话来了。哎，打开了人数视野。Damn.
Boo! Fire these guys. Get actual Genshin players.
哎，对，回到正轨。可以可以。
B rank. Who's that? Who hired the security guard for this? Why would you make the security guard like play the game?
Yeah.
I mean, this is cool and all, like just showing like the time trial stuff in Natlan, but I don't know. I just feel like this is slightly unnecessary.
啊，怎么不换好给我？加油加油！
I mean, it's still fun. Not, don't get me wrong. It's just, I don't know. I kind of want to know more about the events as a whole. Mavuika probably didn't want this weird blonde alien to steal her powers. Probably. You're probably right about that.
原神5.0版本也即将上线，马上就给旅行者们端上来了。到时候我们大家一起去纳塔去体验这些新鲜的玩法吧。期待。旅行者们欢迎回来。Damn,
are they not even gonna talk about the events?
那坐在我身边的呢，就是大家的老朋友，原神的国内市场负责人 Michael。大家好。 这一次说来也巧啊，我们的 5.0 版本刚好撞上周年庆啊。是哎，那说起周年庆，那就必须办。Right,
the anniversary. What are you gonna do for that?
没错，那么在这次 5.0 版本期间呢，通过周年庆的签到活动，我们会为各位旅行者送出10枚纠缠之源。另外，我们也会通过邮件向大家发放。
Okay, 20 pull, satisfying elixir, kaboom box. Okay, so. Same thing as last year, essentially.
23
pulls. I mean, I don't expect Hoyo to go above that anymore, really. I only like, expect that generosity with Star Rail and Get and ZZZ. There's more? Oh? 50 pulls?
这个你见过吗？
这什么？这么厚吗？
Wait, are we actually gonna get more rewards for the anniversary? Yo?
Oh,
optimization changes, okay.
在5.0版本期间, 旅行者们只要完成魔神任务, 荣花与炎日之徒,
oh, 500 people still completing the Archon Quest. Okay.
就可以在活动界面直接领取额外的500元.
That's nice.
刚刚说到的是完成主线就有更多的原石吗?
没错啊。
那... 还有提到一点是5.0版本期间才有, 那是只有5.0才有吗?
哎,那可不是了。在接下来的5.0, 5.1,
5.1 and 5.3 as well,
这篇章发布的这些版本, 都可以拿到这样的限时奖励, 也就是更多的额外的500元石哦。
Okay.
That's,
that means like 1500 primo gems, so close enough to the temple.
Okay. 哎，这些奖励包含额外的原石，以及还有对应的角色等级二和突破等级三所需要的所有培养材料哦。我们就
So does that mean we get extra primo gems just by playing the story quest too?
首先我们会有写示身手的活动，马拉尼可以突破到突破等级一，对不对？嗯。然后因为马拉尼有部族祭文任务，也就是说接下来会陆续。
Oh, cool. Oh, so just free shit to rank them up.
嗯，也就是说，That's
nice.
几乎不用付出任何的额外。
That's very good, actually. That means I don't have to freaking spend hours upon hours of farming. That's really good, actually. So I can just build Mualani right away. Okay. Okay. That's a very good change.
对于新加入的这些旅行者，他们好像不能立刻赶到纳塔。对于他们。 有什么样的安排？那Michael，你的意思是说，假如我是一个初来乍到的旅行者，对的，我没有办法第一时间体会到这些任务，那我就拿不到对应的原始奖励了。这一点我们当然也都考虑到了。
Oh yeah, well, for new players that can't start the quest. Oh, quick start before the Archon quest. Okay.
在5.0版本更新以后，只要完成了璃月的主线，
so as soon as you done with Liyue, you can jump straight to Natlan if you want to.
就是之前还有人会问我嘛，什么时候入坑原神？
Just imagine you just load into Natlan, it's just like, oh, ever since the... ever since we lost the previous Electro Archon, and Sumeru's changed, and Fontaine got rid of Farina as his Archon, man, it's been hard times for those regions. Just, like, spoil the previous regions.
你知道在原神原先的版本里面有一个针对回归玩家的活动，叫新之归还，对。
那么在5.0版本呢，我们对新之归还的奖励也做了一定的调整。原始奖励以外呀，还有一些长期没有回归的，对吧？旅行者们，那这些旅行者呢还会额外。A straight free temple？活动中领取至多10枚纠缠之源。10抽啊！对，具体的参与规则。Okay，that's a much better reward for coming back。Okay。等等，那新玩家。
跟老朋友都照顾到了。Damn, okay, I guess it's the same time to get back to the Genshin, it's now. Per at the 5.0. Oh yeah, QOL changes, is there? Like other than the ones you read earlier, of course. 只要旅行者们点击背包当中对应区域特产的。Oh yeah, okay. They said this in the dev notes on Hoyo Lab. 没错。对，那么现在呢，只要你点击了这个选项，它就会在大地图上自动追踪这些。Yeah,
pretty much show a blue circle where some locations of them are, which is very nice. So I don't need to go look up a thing on the internet.
哇，那也太舒服了吧！那怪物。 的掉落的这个能不能也做一下优化？以前我去收集这个海乱鬼跟漂浮灵的时候，真的太痛苦。Yes.
You understand our pain after two freaking years.
针对这样的一个反馈做了一些调整，在5.0版本更新以后呢，我们特定的一些怪物的材料掉率也会获得提升。
Thank you. took you way too long, but thank you. Finally.
大家可以看到我们视频上面的一些掉落素材的对比啊。
好明显。
对，当然。
Okay, slight improvement, but at least we're not there's not a chance of them dropping absolutely nothing.
所以在5.0版本，我们还推出了。
Because that's the thing, by the way, in the current version.
推出了开放世界。They
can just straight up give you nothing at all.
世界。
Yep, and World Level 9 as well.
那大家会想啊，世界等级九会不会非常困难？ 但是对于这些实力强大的旅行者，他可以很轻松地挑战世界等级九的这些内容的同时呢，还会获得更丰厚的掉落奖励。我必须要强调一下，这些掉落奖励呢也包含。
And yet the rewards are always guaranteed to be three.
让我捋一捋，那就是说，刚刚世界等级提升后的这个增加材料的掉落，以及包括整体的这个怪物掉落的这个内容的增加。 两个效果是可以叠加的吗？没错，这两个效果是完美叠加的。所以
Michael， 你的理解能力很强啊！哇，这那有点不得了啊！Michael， 你已经听到这里了，难道你不觉得？Also,
damn, the OST playing right now is very relaxing. Man, I want to hear the battle OST though. The like the Natlan battle OST.
觉得应该优化的，那你们有安排吗？啊，那当然了，那当然了，就是圣遗物啊。我觉得大家这么多年下来啊，对于原神的圣遗物，主要是吐槽两个点啊，就是第一个点叫圣遗物转狗粮，第二个点叫一个极品圣遗物的胚子。我们先说圣遗物分解的事情啊，旅行者们在分解圣遗物之前，不是只能分解出摩拉吗？
Oh, hey, it's a thing from Starreal and Genshin.
Zenless. Okay,
so just quick salvage.
Nice.
I definitely need that. My out of space is like just always full now.
对吧，我也没错，没错。好，那刚才 Michael 其实提了一个很重要的问题啊，就是他如果到了关键的时候，却又没有办法为后续的角色获取对应的圣遗物，就会感觉自己很矛盾，对不对？对的，嗯。那么除了圣遗物转化为培养材料以外呢，我们还推出了第二个很重磅的功能，叫做祝圣光。Sanctifying
Elixir.
这个名字听起来有点厉害。Wait,
can we just straight up create an artifact just all on our own? Subsets and main sets and everything.
祝圣之霜来兑换指定词条的圣物。Yo,
we also get to choose the subsets too?
没错，这个指定词条不仅能够
Oh, fuck yes.
主词条的属性种类,
Thank you.
还可以额外指定两个副词条的属性。
Wait.
那我的双爆岂不是...
对, 跟你想的一样。
Oh, so it's not...
祝圣之霜呢, 大家可以通过萃取一定数量已经升级的圣遗物, 或者说探索纳塔的大世界,
Oh, you can also create it on your own, okay.
进行达到指定的等级来获取。
And of course, it's the BP too.
刚才我们是不是有提到周年庆的邮件奖励?
对。
So we can just create an artifact all on our own. Subsets, main sets, everything. Okay, good. Very good. I can finally just create that fucking off piece I needed for my fucking Art of Kino for a while. Okay, BB rewards will be adjusted.
首先是在进行开始的时候, 旅行者们就可以从这四种养成资源中任选其中三种,
Oh, you can choose what you need, okay.
可获取的奖励,
nice.
如果你可以通过自己的需求来查漏补缺了。此外呢,
Okay, not bad. Because, yeah, I definitely don't need the ores anymore.
达到对应等级之后, 我们原本指定国家的,
now you can choose per region now, okay.
Alright,
pretty good QL changes. Very good, actually.
你现在说的真的是原神吗?
Michael, 你还记不记得, 我们的旅行者, 为了去提升我们队伍的体力上限, 他必须得把蒙德和黎月的齐天神像供奉至满级, 对不对?
Yeah? Are we gonna get more stamina?
对啊,不然玩家直接到了纳塔, 或者说体验其他的国度, 他就...
体力值就没有办法展开。
没错，所以既然我们做了主线快速开启，那么一定要把相关的所有的细节都优化到底。嗯，从 5.0 版本更新开始，旅行者们就可以通过供奉任意区域的
技能
形象来增加自己的体力值上限了。与此同时呢，从纳塔开始，纳塔的精神像、纳塔的地灵龛，还有类似像枫丹露景泉这样的纳塔独有的供奉系统，也将会提供更多的原始奖。
Oh, cool. Okay, so the chest will.
我帮大家算了一下。
Nice.
The
chest will give you more primos. Nice.
加起来的总和有超过十枚纠缠
之源的奖
励哦。
Is our stamina gonna remain the same all the time, or it's just like for newbies, basically? Like leveling up any statue will just give you stamina. Hmm.
结束了吧？
你希不希望？你希不希望这个
？Please give me some more. No, give me more like resin or something, like more resin cap.
那当然是。
Oh my god, how many more do you have?
Michael, 你要知道啊，或者我们的旅行者大家要知道，一般节目的高潮啊都要留到后面的，所以到迄今为止我都还没有说到重量的信息。
Wait.
大伟哥。来之前完全没有跟我说过有这些东西啊。
Please be something big.
我也不做，顺序安排由 Michael 自己去抽一张。
那我先抽这个吧，
先抽这个对不对？你觉得你确定？
确定。
Please be like, I don't know, just something good.
嗯，刚才啊，我们有一位朋友说到过。希望他能够把玩家
hoping could transfer plays bad luck to 50-50 to himself. Wait.
我们也很佩服这位旅行者的勇气。
Is Toronto gonna lose every 50-50 from now on in exchange for our benefits?
可以些微的分担一下这位旅行者的负担。Michael, 你想不想替各位旅行者先体验一下？
那我就替各位旅行者先验验货了啊。
好，那么麻烦我们的工作人员。
Wait, are they like fixing the 50-50 system?Okay.
好 ，Michael， 试试看。
嗯。哎，这个特效怎么跟之前的不一样了呀？
Wait.
不会是我欧皇附体了吧？
这其实
They change wishing animation. Oh, is it different if you win 50-50?
新加入的一个事件叫做捕获明光。
Capturing radiance.
明光这是什么东西？
我给你们解释一下。
What is that?
就是当玩家呀常说的小保底到来的时候。
A chance to encounter the capturing radiance event when wishing on 50-50.
当这次事件的时候呢？抽取的结果必定为
Oh, okay, so different animation if you're guaranteed the 5-star. Okay.
这个事件会挤占以前的大小保底的概率吗？
哎，知道你就会这么问，我相信旅行者们也非常关心这样一个问题。那么捕获明光，它关键就关键在它只是单纯提高了小保底抽中当下的机会，
okay.
并不会影响这个游戏其他所有的概率规则。也就是说，你简单理解为我们抽中当下 up 的。
So when you're 50-50, you have a higher chance of getting the character. Okay, okay. I'm not sure how much it's increased by, but that's nice.
接下来还有吗
？Michael, 你觉得这个消息都不算爆炸性消息是吗？
我觉得已经挺爆炸了。
I do this and they do this and when we still lose 50-50, then we're just gonna complain.
它是这三个消息中最不爆炸的一个。
The least major? Okay.
武器神柱复兴。
Oh, did they change the weapon banner?
记得先定轨哦。
哎。
One fate point, good.
数字好像有点问题。
Good, no two more fate, no two fate points. Oh yeah, please let them carry over too. Please.
从 5.0 版本更新开始，我们的神柱复兴起源，也就是武器池。它的定轨上限会从二调整到一。
Fucking finally.
哎，什么不会吧？
对策划的。
Please let it carry over as well. Don't let it go away by the next banner.
会从别的地方把它抠回来的。
啊，你看 ，Michael 的这个质问就非常的，让我非常的有既视感啊。但是我还是得，坦诚的跟大家讲，这一次武器的起源定轨，我们真的只是把它从二下调到了一，仅此而已。我们没有变动其他所有原有的规则。
Okay, so your fate points still go away.
最后一条。更劲爆的消息。
I mean that's fine. At least it's reduced to one now, instead of freaking pulling two 5-stars before getting the one you want.
我只是玩家的嘴替，我开个玩笑。
哎，我可没有在开玩笑。
Okay, what's this last big change?
确实是真诚的，想给大家再送上一次非常劲爆的福利。
难道说？
没错。那么在今天呢，我在这里。
A final benefit for okay. What is it?
最后一条福利投放的消息。也就是从今年开始，每年原神的周年庆版本期间，我们都会向已经解锁了
Free 5-star，Let's go！
所有旅行者
提供一次免费获取。
Oh, the, it, this is the same thing as in Starry on ZZZ. Finally.
所以不仅是一个自选的常驻五星，还是每年一个自选常驻五星。
Every year from now on?
没有听错，
你确定吗
？From the standard banner? Yo, let's go! I can finally fucking see for my gene. Let's do. Let's go.
从今年开始，每年原神的。
We've been asking this for fucking ages.
自选常驻五星的机会。
而且我们的这个常驻词是一直加新角色。
People can finally get the character they want on the standard banner. Let's go.
角色加入到奔行世间起源当中，也就是说每年的这个福利也会随着版本的推进。
Oh, and they're also adding, trying to add more characters to standard banner as well.
你觉得？
Oh, that's very good. That's a very fucking good change. I can finally see for my gene.
我真的有点懵啊，就是。哇，我没想到今天的福利居然是这样的。
我感觉你的心情还没有从
我
刚才的
我有点
这些消息中
缓过来。That is a very good change. I gotta say.
那我也想代表团队呢。
Took them freaking forever to give out a free 5-star though, but fine, we'll take it now.
开发者，但同时我们也是原神的玩家，这一点一直从 1.0 开始。我都在不断地跟大家传达这样一个信息。那么玩家提出的一切的问题，我们作为玩家当然也都是感同身受的。
是的，
因为原神接下来要走的路也很困难也很长，但是我希望它能够一直延伸下去。我们能够一直走下去也离不开大家一直以来的持续关注和支持。
没错。
那么接下来就到了 Michael 的回合了。
虽然我觉得我们所准备的内容不如刚刚的惊喜，但是我们准备的周年庆相关内容呢，比往年还是。
Okay, yep. I gotta say, at the very least, this anniversary seems to be a lot better than the previous ones. They at least improved on that.
就非常满足了。
Good and hoyo.
平时也非常重视每位旅行者的声音。我觉得项目组的大家其实都是发自内心的去认可，还是要以高品质的核心内容创作作为它最重要的基石。我们要持续不断地去做出好内容本身，这才是我们一直能够走下去的立身之本。那如果说我们做的内容没有让玩家，没有让旅行者感受到乐趣，那一定是我们哪里出现了问题。我们会非常非常乐意去收集大家的看法进行调整。
七哥突然之间感慨起来了呢。
那么接下来啊，
I mean, yeah, Genshin may not be the perfect game in the world, but at least the devs themselves are trying. Whoa, what's this?Yo! Animation? Hey, yo, my boy Kinich! Whoa, this is like. Holy shit, this is like Spider-Verse vibes right now. Holy shit. Yo, let's go, my boy! Yeah, this is totally like Spider-Verse animation right now. Holy shit. Oh, run, Kachina! This animation is so fucking clean, holy shit. Yo! Cool, oh my god. Oh my god, these animation frames though? Holy shit. Are they fucking racing? What is this? Yo! Kill the giant fatty. Blaze to Natlan. Okay, now that was a promotional teaser, not the ones you saw earlier. Oh, and there you go, final redemption code, folks. Hey, look at that! All 6 Archons. Ah, and we're only just missing one now. Damn. Also, yeah, let me post this final redemption code to you guys. Be sure you claim it because it will expire, well, in a month, but...Well, no, actually, the redemption code, I think, expires in 12 hours, so claim that quick. The mail will go away in 30 days. There you go. I hope I typed that right. But yeah, copy and paste it and claim your primos before it goes away. Yo, look at that, though. Aw, look at Frieza and Nahida holding the candles. Aw, man. I can't wait for mavuika to join the Archon family. That is gonna be great.But yeah, so far, this is a pretty goated live stream. Holy shit. It was so good so far. Man. How long have we been here? Oh, you've been here for like a whole ass hour. Holy shit. Imagining the interchanges?
And 5.0, okay.
What's changing? We just had the wondrous boon events in the gameplay. Okay.
在新的版本当中呢，这些事件将根据当期的三元素所对应的反应体系进行有效清晰的策略引导。简单来讲，就是你拿到这个注意的时候，就已经知道他应该给什么样的东西。
Oh, okay. So,
老实说，之前
this pretty much just assists new players who don't like to read all the buffs.
Okay.那这些注意事件呢，也就是他们是贴合原有的反应体系去制作的。
Hey, look, Emily, the one character that everybody's skipping right now. Probably not. They're probably just going to be just as difficult as before. Oh, you can enable hard mode, okay. Oh, and it's extra rewards for hard mode? Ooh, that's good. Oh, yep, and of course TCG changes. Yo, Xianyun is here. I haven't played TCG in a good while, actually. I've been so busy with like everything else. I almost like never have any time for it. Collaboration events? Oh, Logitech, okay. I thought it was gonna be like as insane as a Fate collab with Starrio. No, no, it's just... You can get a free Ayaka gaming chair.
Man,
like Hoyo has been like collabing with like a lot of tech companies lately. Oh, yes, music. Please play us some banger tracks right now.
接下来就请旅行者们拿起手边的花生瓜子饮料矿泉水入席就坐，纳塔交响音乐会马上开始。
Oh, we're getting actual performance? Yo! Natlan Live Symphony performance. Okay, shout out for this one. Hold up, I gotta turn up the volume in my headset for this one. Whoa, yo! Is actually gonna be like straight singing in Natlan? I hope so. Yo, this music sounds fucking grand as hell. I love it. Yo, this music sounds fucking fire. Is this the battle theme? Or is this like one of the city themes? Maybe. Like the hub themes. Yo, I'm loving this track already.
Yo,
Do you feel dead? Yo, I'm getting goosebumps right now. Holy shit. Oh, man. This sounds so good already. The main theme, probably. Oh, it sounds so, so good already. Even before they use this for an emotional moment in the Natlan soundtrack. And ruined it for all of us. Oh, no, not the Natlan story, I mean. It sounds so fucking grand, I love it. Natlan. Yo. This is the best soundtrack so far in Genshin, no lie, no cap. Yo, sounds like the Lion King soundtrack? Kinda does, in a sense. Oh, more? Anthem of the Sav. Oh, battle theme? Ooh, battle theme, probably. Oh. That's a fucking great start to a battle. Prepare to hear this soundtrack for like all but 5 seconds before you demolish a hillature on your way. Man, it's just one thing that's perfect about Genshin, it's a soundtrack. Holy shit. Oh, let me hear that bass drop, baby. Let me hear that bass drop. The scene? Yo! I can't really help but feel like the lyrics mean something for like the main story. They're probably like symbolizing something we don't know about. Yo! This battle theme was a fucking bop. Oh Oh my god. Props to Genshin's music team. Oh my god. God bless Hoyo Mix. Yo! It's still going? How long is this battle theme? That more singing? I'm gonna delay all the battles just to listen to this theme in its entirety. Just saying. You burn a cinders for a dream. Oh my god, I legit have chills. Oh yeah, bring in those fucking symbols. Great fucking soundtrack, holy shit. Oh man, that sounds so, so fucking good. Oh, sex with my fucking ears. My goodness. We're also collabing with Fate.
在此之前我想提个题外话。 就是在到7.0版上线的那一年，我记得有一个海外媒体的朋友有问我一个问题，说这一年的开发感受，如果用一个词来概括的话，你觉得什么样的词最合适？那当时我其实用了一个词叫进化，这个词不光是指我们整个团队为了去做更多原先从未体验过的内容所做出的个人努力，所做出的团队的进化。 另一方面，其实也是，直到今天，大家看到的像纳塔这样的内容，也是我们这个进化之路上的其中一小步。那每年我们都会努力的做出一些让大家眼前一亮的、有新概念的内容呈现给大家。那刚才大家也有问，在故事上我们有没有什么长线规划？我们会在未来的旅途上遇到更多的伙伴和敌人。那么他们其中有一些呢，一直活在坊间传闻当中，那还有一些呢，可能信物质和玩家只有一面之缘，玩家和他们也不甚了解。那还有一些呢，可能他们对旅行者是陌生的，对于提瓦特的众人也是陌生的。但是这些人和世界的命运之间也是息息相关的。那旅行者前往寻找自己血亲的这个旅途，实际上也会和这个世界之间的联系，因为上述的原因越来越紧密。那么基哥也给我们介绍了很多原神未来的规划。
It's coming to an end. Four years of Genshin Impact. And my god, it's been a ride. Hey, hands up if you're a day one player. I am. I've been with Genshin with all its ups and downs, and yeah, here's hoping Natlan is a massive up.
Oh man.
Twitter.
难免让项目组和我都有点不知所措。我自己回想起原神这一路走来啊，其实旅行者的热情、期望与反馈啊，让我们有了不断前行的这个动力啊，也是原神啊能够不断进步的这个源泉。于是啊，今年上半年啊，原神项目组和我决定去跟世界各地的旅行者面对面聊聊。我们去了很多我们从来没有去过的城市，比如湖北襄阳啊，比如巴西圣保罗啊。 在跟全球各地的旅行者面对面的时候啊， 每一位旅行者都非常激动地跟我们分享他们的提瓦特旅程啊。他们有的还在每天体验原神，有的呢只是新版本更新上来体验一下。
I'm still playing it daily.
已经很久没有来过提瓦特。跟他们聊完呢，制作组和我重新理解了旅行的意义啊。我们的脑子里啊想起了那句啊。
Oh yeah, true. The anime.
终将重逢啊。
Are you gonna say anything about it? It's been like 2 years since it was announced.
是原神唯一不能改变的，其他一切皆可改变。
I completely forgot about the anime, not gonna lie.
我们才有机会在未来带来更多精彩优质的内容。最后呢，我们将在8月28日
August 28th. That's a terrible time for me because I'll be busy during that period, but I'll try it soon be there.
前去探索。感谢大家一直以来的支持与陪伴，愿你们的纳塔之旅充满惊喜与期待。旅行者们，我们纳塔见。
See you in Natlan. Man, this is a very good special program. Holy shit. Might be one of their best so far.What's that say? I can't be Chinese. What does that say? Probably like thank you or something.
很放松，比我们之前这个我在场的时候要轻松很多。
鸡哥怎么回事？都不提前跟我。
But yeah, a very, very, very good special program. One of their best. All the QL changes and whatnot. And yeah, all the story and stuff and characters and whatnot and the region as well. I'm so excited for everything. Oh man. I absolutely cannot wait for it. Fuck man, it sucks. I'm gonna have to be extremely busy around September.But I'll still try to be there no matter what. Up to Vat Talks. Anniversary messages from the cast.
Hello, travelers.
Yo, Zach and Koi.
I'm Zach Aguilar, voice of Ether, co-hosting with my friend and voice of Albedo, Koi Dao.
You might as well see this like, before we stop for the day.
Friends. like that one time you played Wind Trace without me.
Hey, everyone.Genshin Impact invited us to be part of the 4th anniversary celebration this year. 4 years.
I wanted to do. Does Zach and Koi still stream together?
I can't believe it.
Because damn, the time they did was super fucking funny.
I've had the pleasure of delivering some epic grunt sounds as Ether, voicing emotional dialogue in the Archon Quests, and working on the special programs. So many great memories have been made not only working on the game, but also playing it. What do you think, Koi?
Oh my gosh, 4 years. Wow. You know, I turned 4 years old once. It was awesome.
I'm sure it was. I don't remember it though.
I never thought I'd get to voice such a cool and intelligent character in an exciting game like Genshin Impact. We know that many of our fellow castmates have had some fun, sometimes truly unbelievable experiences over the past 4 years. So let's bring in a few special guests to, as Albedo might say, Turn the unknown into the known.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
We're gonna get here.
Happy
Yo, Nahida.
Anniversary, everyone. I'm Kimberly Ann Campbell, the voice of Nahida. And I know what you're thinking. A lot of people are like, wow, you sound so different from Nahida.
Obviously.
A rare live stream for me, someone in the chat told me to prove that I was actually the voice of Nahida. So both online and in person at conventions, I get a handful of people who seem to be very surprised that that voice comes out of my body.
It's called voice acting for a reason, so yeah.
That's what I sound like. I usually whip out a everyone hold hands to prove I'm not lying.
Yeah, that's super relatable. Like, I usually just scream Windblade at people to prove that it's me. Or make a huh sound.
Or even just in your private moments.
Yeah.
I've heard you scream it.
Exactly.
What?
I turn to my right side
you wanna,
and I scream
huh?
Windblade! It helps scare away the demons.
Koi, how do you know this?
That's weird. You're a weird guy.
Anyways, here's more guests.
Yeah, we're just gonna ignore that. Yo, Raiden.
I get to see a lot of Genshin.
Oh, we're getting all the Archon VAs in here.
Especially the Raiden Shogun cosplayers at conventions all over the world. And it's so cute when fans come up to my table and realize that I don't usually sound like her. So someone will come up and say, Oh, are you the voice of Raiden Shogun? Oh, yeah, that's me.
can you do a line? And I'll be like, Inazuma shines eternal. And watching their eyes light up always.
I would love to meet one of these VAs in person, like a lie. I met Koi in person. But the others, not so. I've also met Laura Stahl as well. Yo! Keith!
When Genshin Impact dropped, almost immediately, my life began to change in a measurable way. I began to meet more and more people online, at conventions, and honestly, in my daily life, who are so passionate about this game. And I've learned that I love to sneak up on Genshin Impact cosplayers, and then when I'm right behind them, say something like,
"Also met this one.
This is an age of gods and monsters."
No, he didn't
I
do the line.
Not for dominion. Yet I cannot watch the common folk suffer. I mean, the reactions are genuinely priceless. And I frequently hear from people online that that was one of the highlights of their con. I meet people that are so excited about this game that they literally tear up. I mean, honestly, how lucky am I to be a part of something like that?
We all appreciate the Genshin voice actors in this community, except for the ones
so
that did wrong.
Sweet. And that is such a fun
what, no
thing
venti?
To do at
Come
conventions.
On, bring in Erica.
Can you imagine sneaking up on people and suddenly speaking in voice? Except I just get really shy.
Yeah.
Come on, bring up Erica.
Okay.
Yo,
off,
newbie, okay.
Thank you to the team.
I guess he counts as an Archon, technically.
The most beautiful man I have ever seen. Seriously, Nouvellet is a prized character of mine, one I'm just so excited to play and dig into for years to come. Well, he does have a range of subtle emotional beats and some true cathartic twists. Nothing about him can possibly compare to the elephant seal in the room. The month of Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinal changed my life forever. And who could possibly have seen that coming? Genshin Impact fans are so polite whenever I meet them. They never ask me to say it, but of course I always do. And their gratitude about, he said the thing, is always a palpable delight. All right, let's do it.
Say it again. Mechanista de Liz Cardinal. Yes.
Thank you. He said the thing.
He said the thing.
He did say the thing. You say the thing.
Oratrice Mechanique de Liz
Cardinal. Holy shit. I forgot you voice Moon Carver.
Yippee. Yippee. So who's the most beautiful man you've ever seen, Zach? There's a correct answer.
When I looked into your eyes, Koi.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, the ship is real.
I knew that the most beautiful man I ever saw was the reflection in your eyes, me!
I knew it.
Yeah.
I knew it. I knew that's where it was going.
Hair flip.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah. Thanks for coming,
come on,
everybody.
I guess Erica's busy or something.
Awesome.
Damn.
4 years of Genshin Impact.
So much happened.
Damn.
Yeah.
We've got some surprises.
Brought in three out of the five, six Archons.
Tivat talks.
Actually, yeah, why didn't Farina's voice actor show? I wonder. That's nice, though. Oh! Wait, more? More from the cast?
Welcome
Yo!
I'm Sarah Miller Cruz, the English voice of Lumine, and joining me are my lovely co-hosts, Crystal and Jenny.
Jenny, let's go!
Hi, everybody. Crystal Lee here. I voice Clarand, the legendary champion duelist herself. Pew pew pew.
Pew pew pew.
Hello. It is me. I have returned. It is Jenny Okobori. I am the voice of Yoimiya.
Oh yeah, Clarin is also Rena, right? Yeah.
Joy with all of you out there.
I see what you did there.
Speaking of the anniversary, how are you two celebrating this amazing milestone?
Oh, one heck of a milestone.
I'm celebrating it by
That's like enough to get a bachelor's degree.
Skipping my exams for Genshin 5.0.
University. That's what I'm doing.
I'm not gonna really do that, but still, I'm tempted to.
I haven't planned anything specific yet, but I'm sure I'll play more Genshin Impact as usual. Come on, you've been in this game since the beginning.
You should see your twin, Sarah.
Nothing? No. Listen. I've been looking for him for four long years. Okay.
Have you now?
Crystal, you mentioned that you're going to graduate. I think I'm going to enroll in grad school so I can stay here for as long as I can.
Yes.
I'm enjoying
sure.
my time.
Because that's the best move. Get that PhD. Yeah. Get that postdoc.
I am very much a person that is motivated by sweet little treat culture, and so I just want to know when my next sweet little treat's going to be, and I think I want to indulge in a cake. I want to get one of the Genshin Impact birthday cakes that they send you on your birthday.
Do they make Genshin birthday cakes?
And I want one.
Yes. Oh, wait, they do, yeah. I want to... Let's go ahead. I don't know what character I want, actually.
What they have to say about this momentous occasion.
Yay!
I probably want Shenhe's cake.
Happy anniversary, Genshin!
Yeah, Shiari!
I'm so humbled to be part of such a vast world and talented cast. When I auditioned for Shiari, I felt such a connection to her inner strength as a fellow AFAB business owner, who is often told they are intimidating, who was discouraged at the beginning of their career, and who has big aspirations. Throughout the recording, Shiari has continued to inspire me through her bold and individualistic style, and I hope to have brought a bit of me to
you. Gotta say, though, even though not a lot of people pull for Shiori, I still really, really love her.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Wait, that's
lovely. I love that.
I love Brittany.
That is so
She's still
great.
Fun to play, even after all this time.
I really love how, like, Genshin Impact shows a lot of really strong women, you know? Like, a business owner as, like, being one of such example. That's amazing.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. And I feel like a lot of us do feel such connections to our characters, and that's partially what I think, you know, like helps us
really connect,
bring them to life. You know what I mean? I feel like I'm a lot like Lumine because I also have a twin brother in real life.
Yes.
Oh, really? Now I didn't know that.
I just can't find him anywhere. For the We Are Reunited quest is like so special and emotional for me. Honestly, I've gotten teary-eyed basically every single time we've recorded Ether and Lumine getting to be together again because I really cannot imagine how horrible it would be to be separated from my twin brother. It just like makes me so emotional.
That's cute, actually. I had no idea Sarah Miller had a twin brother.
The direction for the opening cutscene where they get separated, it actually made me cry. The end.
Yep, who else?
I love to laugh, if you can tell. And I love to laugh as Farina, especially.
She's here!
Some of my favorite booth moments involve doing her variety of laughs. I also kept cracking up later on when she's directing and shouts, "Action!" I had so much fun doing those in a variety of ways, and I'm so, so happy the team liked the variety, and even
I really, really do love Farina's, like, VA. Isn't she a director now? Like, voice director for... Was it Star Rail, I think?
One of my
or Zenless? I don't remember.
...to do was when Farina was on stage, reliving all those different moments from her past up to the current day. I'm not joking when I say I couldn't stop crying in the booth while recording those. Legit.
No.
Tears for days.
Oh. That's a lot of tears today. That's a lot of, my gosh.
Yeah, it's a lot of crying.
I was talking about things that make them emotional.
Right. Gosh.
I'm just like, I'm gonna keep saying this because just because I love so much of our cast, but I'm like, I love Amber, and
she's
also, like,
amazing.
It's very true. Like, she does love to laugh. She's a close friend of mine, and I can confirm that. So.
She's the voice director of ZZ, yeah. Oh, sweet. Like, I hope she voices a character at some point in there as well.
And relate so well. It's one of the most incredible things. And, like, seriously, Farina has some of the cutest laughs ever.
Absolutely agree. Yeah.
We stand best go for Arena.
Well, okay. I mean, back to the question, though. What about you, Jenny?
Okay, so, I mean, my first job when I moved out to LA was actually being a pyrotechnician.
Wait, no way.
Really?
That's amazing.
What?
I had
What a fucking
a
coincidence.
Fully intended, by the way, at that job. And it really helped shape who I am. And I honestly feel like
you just imagine just
meant for each other. It definitely feels like fate.
Oh, you just looked at her resume. It's just like, yep, you're perfect for the firework girl.
Yumi and I are extremely bubbly and very talkative, as you guys have probably picked up on by now. However,
and we love you both for it.
Thank you. However, I think the most meaningful similarity is the love we both feel for our disabled fathers. My father has since passed, but I grew up as a primary caretaker for my father who had Alzheimer's. So seeing Yoimiya interact and help her father really struck a chord with me.
Yeah.
I'm getting a little bit choked up.
I love how each of the voice actors just seem to correlate in some essence to, like, the characters. That's a very, very, like, nice,
present company
like,
included.
Yeah. Connection between them and their characters.
Including her Japanese voice actor, who I got to meet last year.
And oh yeah, so that happened.
Oh my gosh. And I've also just seen so much of the world through conventions. Yeah. It's such an unbelievable honor to lend my voice to.
I think they did like the Spider-Man just, pointing like, meme at each other when they first met.
Brings joy to so many people all over the world.
You do such a beautiful job of it too.
Thank you.
Aww.
When
yeah!
I was like, yay! I'm so excited to be a bard because I love singing. Yay! So whether Vine Lisa Fest.
Now we got all five archons here. Let's go.
Perform it at the end of the event and he keeps saying the word song. So when we got to that final performance, I was like, hey, just for funsies. Since we're.
Hey, Hoyo, please. When? Venti Act 2, when? Please.
And the team
we
like,
need
sure,
it.
If you can come
we
up with
need a Venti Act 2.
We can do it just for fun. So I went on break for like 5 minutes and came back with a little tune for the lyrics and then recorded it in one take. It was super fun.
One take?
But
damn.
I didn't expect them to actually use it in the game because, like I've said 5,000 times, it was just for fun. And so when the event came out and people started excitingly tagging me in posts about Venti singing, I was so shocked and so excited. Oh my gosh. And it was just so sweet to see how much Venti singing meant to the fans. Like the reactions were so heartwarming and I was so happy.
I still love Venti as well, even after all this time.
You know, but I'm also happy to go back to his
I wish you'd come back more often.
Really happy that I got to sing at least once in the game.
Yeah, the burden of being the first Archon.
Oh,
wait, yeah.
Incredible.
Gosh. She just came up with the tune like
yes,
spontaneously just there
right on the spot.
That's
I love it.
It's Erica for you. I mean,
I
like
know,
listen.
I know. And
girl,
like I don't know.
Erica's very talented. Yeah.
Song from that event, but it is
after witnessing so many
good.
For roles, yeah, she's
Erica
a very very talented lady.
That's incredible. One
she's
take,
so
5 minutes.
She's so talented.
Just,
she really is.
She's so talented.
That's crazy.
I know.
Oh
well,
gosh.
Okay, so we've been hearing about how all these people feel like a connection to their character, and I was wondering, Crystal, if
oh.
you have an answer to that.
Oh yeah. My gosh.
Ooh, juicy.
I mean, yeah, no, I think one of the things that really brought me so close to Cloran was when I found out she was a secret nerd. Like,
yeah.
The second I found out she plays tabletop.
She plays fucking D&D. That's just like, oh my god, we love her already.
Friends, like Navia. And I was like, that's crazy, because
yeah.
I walked in, and everyone on the call was like, hey, so, I don't know if you know about tabletop, or like, you know, certain games involving tabletop, and I was
yeah.
like, are you kidding me? I live for that stuff. It's I love it so much, and so to be able to bring that side to her was just so incredibly fun, and I loved connecting with how much she... like, she's secretly super, super friendly. Like, you don't
yeah.
expect it when you meet her. She's, like, super stoic and, like,
yeah.
down to business. But secretly, she's just out here loving her friends and, like, supporting people. And, yeah, I don't know. I loved that aspect of her. She just felt... She really came alive when I found that much more about her personal life beyond
yes.
her role in the court. It was so much fun. And
that's so
yeah,
cute.
I love
that.
Her so much. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Well, it's been so great to hear from all these different actors. I've loved this. This is great.
This is really fun.
This was really, really good.
Yeah.
I'm glad that they're doing this.
Like,
it feels special for
like
yeah, these anniversaries in particular.
Yes.
A little
yeah.
peek behind the curtain, if you will.
Exactly.
Yes.
And I still can't believe it's been 4 years. I feel like no time at all has passed somehow. Like, and also all the time has passed. Like, time.
It's so surreal. It really
it
is.
Who knows?
Well,
oh my
hey.
Gosh.
I mean,
well, this has been great. I've had so much fun with y'all today.
Same. And I can't wait for the next. So, I mean, hey, everyone,
yeah.
stay tuned for more. And happy anniversary, travelers.
Yes!
Happy anniversary, 4th one. Oh, we're not done yet. Yo, Joe and Sayu, let's go.
Hello, everybody. This is Alejandro Saab, voice of Sino, and thanks for tuning in.
Man, how long is this going
to
go for? How many VAs?
Hey,
oh, shit out of VAs. We
here wishing everybody a
like, damn.
Genshin Impact 4-year anniversary.
Yeah, same. Dude, I can't believe it's been 4 years. Oh, my gosh. I remember when the game first started, and I was like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And now I'm like, I know a little bit of what I'm doing.
Yeah, I don't think I've even reached a little bit. I think, like, when I stream the game...
I think Joe stopped at Mondstadt.
I don't know what I'm doing at all.
I don't think you even got
the
Fontaine.
And it's just this... Genshin Impact has become this whole massive world. Like, who could have imagined?
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, so I totally get it. So, without further delay, let's check out what our voice actors have to say about this landmark occasion in our journey.
Yep.
Hi, I'm Erin.
Yo, Arlecchino.
The voice of the Knave, aka Arlecchino. Oh, aka Father. We've recorded many Arlecchino scenes.
It's honestly surprising really the difference between her regular voice and Arlecchino.
Most normally are those that explored her moments of vulnerability.
I'm not used to this. I'm not used to Arlecchino sounding friendly.
In those few intimate moments with her children or with Clairvy, I knew we made something special while in the booth, but oh boy. Watching the finished sequences with all the other actors' performances in there instantly made me so proud to be a part of this cast. And yes, it's also quite fun to play her viciously cool and aloof yet badass sides too. So thank you all for letting me be a small piece of this huge narrative adventure. And for being
thank you for being one of the most badass characters in Genshin so far.
Congrats on 4 amazing years, Genshin. Here's to many more.
Man, Arlecchino is so cool, and I absolutely adore
I hope Capitano is just as cool, if not even cooler.
Just sad at times.
Capitano better be a fucking badass.
For these characters, you know?
Yeah, and sometimes like you don't know what the work's gonna be until you get there. One of my favorite lines of Risley's is, if the Duke wants somebody dead, he needs no justification. And a lot of people don't know that it's one of the first scenes we ever did in the booth. And I remember thinking like, whoa, this guy's like rough. He's a prison warden. He's over here saying he's above the law. Okay, I guess you know, we'll play him tough, right? We'll play really rough. And then it turned out that he was this really intelligent, respectable, even like kind man. Yeah. And so I just had to take that toughness that was, you know, kind of right out the gate and then apply it to his otherwise really formal language. He speaks really intelligently. But he's also got this kind of like blue-collar spirit that makes for a super interesting mix. It was just one of those fun experiments in character development on the fly.
Yeah, yeah. Moments like that are absolutely awesome, especially when portraying these
characters
that have so many layers and so many dimensions. I mean, in Sino's second story,
we all love our best boy, Risley.
So many layers of Sino, you know.
That might be a hot take, actually.
To his friends after so many patches in Genshin Impact, you know, like he's like, oh, let's play Genius Invocation TCG. Here's a random joke. But it's cool that we finally got to, you know, a nice reminder that he's still the general Mahamantra.
Yeah, and it, like all of us have our own little stories about how we came to it, and they're all really unique. So let's see how some others spent their time behind the mic for this.
Yeah.
All right, who else now?
First of all, congratulations on 4 years, you cute people. I mean, wow, I have been part of the incredible Genshin Impact universe for almost exactly a year.
Voice of Yunli and Navia, and honestly, God bless her. Her performance is so good for both of them.
From the team at mihoyo, and our voice directors, to the hardworking studio crew, and the players around the globe. There is such an incredible energy tying us all together. When we started our records and I dove into Navia's emotional roller coaster of a backstory, I knew that this game was something special. I mean, Malus and Silver still make me tear up just thinking about them.
Oh yeah. Rip to them.
Oh man, Silver and Malus. I miss those guys. They were so cool. They were funny, but
yeah, why did he have to die off in the Archon Quest? Like, come on.
Yeah, I can't wait to meet him. I haven't gotten to that part of the game yet, so before we get into any spoilers, let's hear from Amber and Stephanie.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Amber?
Congratulations on the 4th anniversary.
I thought for this year Amber the character.
Most exciting for me because I get to be
I forgot Emily's VA is also named Amber.
Story and beauty, but also a great community of players. Emily was such a fun character to play. She's calm during stressful or terrifying situations, yet gentle when it's called for. She can read the room and sniff problems out pretty quickly, too. I knew she had to be mature enough to have the smarts and kind enough to care for others. Her character impressed me every day in the studio. When I found out which character I was to play and her impact in the game, I was on a break in studio and the engineer told me Emily was the main character for this update.
Oh.
Initially, I didn't understand. But then once we recorded more and more, it hit me. I am now part of the Genshin Impact family, which is pretty awesome. It is a true honor. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for playing Emily.
I still
Yo, Sienyun, hey!
Game for nearly 4 years. It's wild to think that I
Sienyun, my beloved.
But I am so proud of getting to play her. Not only is she a character that has helped me stretch my own vocal range, but she's also so full of life and mystery and so unintentionally hilarious.
Oh yeah, she's also been here for like the whole 4 years, right? Because she also, I think she also voices Xianyun in her bird form as well, right?
Every time I would return for events,
before she was even a playable character.
Into other beloved characters through some pretty funny quips or some deeply sad backstories. So when I was asked to give her life as the playable Xianyun, one was over the moon. With her human form, I would be able to share her softer side, the side that we've only had glimpses of. So one was really, one was really loving getting to play the funny, soft, strong, intelligent, sassy, and loving character that she is. I mean, she is the type of character that has made Genshin Impact so special for so many people throughout the years.
True.
So, thank you so much for asking.
People were joking about fucking the bird for a while now before she actually became human. I shit you not. Don't look that up. Love Xianyun, though.
Man, I'm a nerd for this game. I love Genshin Impact.
Oh yeah, we all are.
So many people and all of the actors in this cast just be so excited about it. I'm not gonna lie, it made me tear up a little, and I know that folks are gonna be like, no, you didn't. And I'm like, man, it just makes my heart all warm.
Let the man cry. Like, yeah. Come on, let him feel a little bit.
Let him cook, you know?
The through line here for me is how we have this thing called Genshin Impact, or any story, really, and all we're hearing from actors is that how it evolved, right? Like, no one knows what shape it's gonna take. You just release this thing into the world, and then the collaborative efforts of all these people kind of morph and change.
Like, honestly, it's surprising how big Genshin Impact blew up to be. When I first played it, I was sort of like,
organism, but it's just,
I honestly thought it would like be more of a niche kind of game.
So honored that
I didn't think it'd
be a part of
this big
with you and everybody else,
honestly.
Well, everyone, that's a wrap on Teyvat Talks. Thanks for tuning in.
These 4 years of Genshin Impact have been amazing, and the adventure continues on.
Hey, and that's the end. I feel like they did this just to stretch the stream to like 2 hours long, but it is what it is. Ah, there we go. And there we go, folks. The end of the version 5.0 special program. What a great, great special program. It was honestly so, so good. I cannot wait for this update to come live. Oh, yep, there you go, that's the end. I thought we were gonna get, like, a post-credit scene or something, for some reason. But yep, I absolutely cannot wait for this update to go live. Mualani, Kinich, and Kachina look sick, definitely gonna be pulling for all of them. And the story looks very, very much interesting, and the world as well looks so, so fun to explore. And I cannot wait for the music especially. I'm gonna delay all the battles just to listen to that battle theme in its entirety. Also, look at Ether here, too. Like raising his, like, arms through the head. Also, yeah, what are they running from? I wonder. Also, yeah, can't wait to see more of the man Capitano himself as well as mavuika. I really want to see, like, how these two, like, interact. And their duel at the end of the trailer as well. I cannot wait for that as well. Oh, man. Also, yeah, some pretty good QLR changes all around. And also, better rewards all around. So, hey, maybe this anniversary might be way better than the previous anniversaries. Finally, and yeah, we finally get a free 5-star after all these years. Finally get to, randomly choose a 5-star from the standard banner of your own choosing. So, it's not going to affect me that much because I have every single standard 5-star, but it's going to be useful for me in getting the constellations for them, because I think my gene's about to be C4 and I want it to be C4, so that'd be great. And yeah, finally for you guys, you can finally get one of the 5-stars you don't have after all this time. So yeah, good on you guys. But okay, boys, that is the end of our special program watch party of Genshin 5.0. What do you guys think? Yeah, who are you going to be pulling for out of all these characters? Oh man, it's going to be great. August 28th, that's going to be a very busy time for me, I gotta say. Because it's like, what, kind of like at the end of the month? I think I will stream there on day one, but I won't be available like, I don't know, like, when's the 28th again? 28th is on a Wednesday. Okay, so maybe for that 1 week I'll stream Genshin 5.0, but afterwards I'll be, like, extremely, extremely busy with my university and college stuff. So, oh man. Why are all the good updates for all the games coming out on September, man? Oh man. Like, Jane Doe's releasing in September, and so is Genshin 5.0. It's just so many things happening in September. It's just, oh man, why did I have to be busy during that day? I want to like skip my exams just because to play this. But it's gonna be great though. It's gonna be fucking amazing. I have no doubt in my mind that Hoyo made Natlan one of the most amazing regions they've done so far. No doubt at all in my mind. But okay, boys, that is where I'm gonna end off today's stream, everybody. I'm not gonna be playing much today because I was originally planning to take a rest for today, but as it turns out, Genshin's stream just turned out to be way, way earlier than usual. So I'm gonna head off for now, guys, and probably go ahead and just grind some primos for 5.0. Yeah, let me know in the comments and the chat if you which character you're playing to pull for. Leave a like on the stream as well, because that does really support the channel. And subscribe today because to help me reach my goal of 5k subscribers by the end of the year, because we just recently reached 4.4k subscribers, and we're like 600 on the way there to 5k. So be sure to hit that sub button if you want to help with the channel and whatnot. But okay, boys, that is probably a good place to leave on today's stream, everybody. Thank you all so much for watching. I'm very, very much excited for Genshin 5.0, and I cannot wait for it. And hope you guys are as well. But yeah, good luck to everybody pulling for Mualani, Kinich, or whoever you're planning to pull for in version 5. And yeah, with all that said, guys, thank you all so much for watching once again. Be sure to drop me a follow on Twitch and also subscribe to my YouTube channel as well to see some more content from me. But with all that said, guys, once again, I thank you all so much for watching. It really means a lot to me. And yeah, cannot wait for 5.0 in like about 2 weeks from now. Oh man, it's going to be great. It's going to be magnificent. But okay, boys, it's time for me to get off now and take a rest and, you know, figure out what I'm going to do with my wallet and whatnot. Because, oh man, Zenless and Genshin have me by the balls right now. And so does Star Reel as well. Oh, it's going to be great. It's going to be magnificent. I cannot wait for all of that. But okay, boys, it's time for me to, rest up now, guys. Yeah, you guys have a good one, and have a great rest of your day, or evening, or whatever time zone you're in. Well, that's it, guys. Hope to see y'all again next time. I think I might be streaming next week for some, like, Zenless and maybe some Genshin, who knows. I still have to do Seijin's quest, so I'll probably do one of the following, but yeah. Well, that said, thank you all so much for watching. I probably said that like 5 times at this point, but yeah, truly, truly, thank you all so much for watching. And hope to see you guys again next time. Alrighty, time to go now, guys. See ya!